to say hello to. I know you have to do a couple errands, and you may already have taken off. And if not, I'll do all the introducing today. In fact, that's a pretty good idea. Thank you very much. We have a terrific ragtime concert. Of course, it's the music of Scott Joplin today. And in this concert, we sort of celebrate one of the founders of classic ragtime, somebody who really perfected the form. And the form has turned into many different things. One of the things that it turned into was a variety of piano interpretations. We've got a number of pianists, but we also have people who interpret Joplin on other instruments, little groups. And we're changing the form a little bit and doing all their little individual tricks. There's some very distinctive things. All of these are very creative. We have a whole list of creative people who have done wonders with this use of Joplin. And the real magic is, you know Joplin's a genius because no matter how much we bend it around and twist it and change it, it still comes out sounding like a great ragtime. So that's a credit to the durability of Scott Joplin's rags. The first group we'd like to present is from Germany. We have a number of languages represented today, five in all. If you count a couple of extra bad New England accents, there's no And the first, it seems like we're all going to have to minor in foreign languages in order to be able to present people in the future on these concerts. But we'll do our best to introduce the first group. I'm sure they understand enough English to understand when it is they are being introduced on stage. We'll see if this works. Ladies and gentlemen, from Germany, A.N.I.S.
Thank you.
introduce our next artist. Scott Kirby is a very, very well-known name in ragtime, composer, and performer. Many of the people you see like some rags, too. You probably have heard some of them. But Scott is a very handy gentleman to have around the house, too, because, for example, this Wednesday we had a parade to the Maple Leaf site, and we wanted to present a little music just for fun, have a little opening party. But the piano wasn't there yet. We had getting an actual piano in the Maple Leaf Club site. So naturally, we turned to Scott Kirby, who happens to have a piano in his suitcase, and he rolled one out. You think I'm joking? We opened the door across the street. There's his piano. He plays on the streets in New Orleans with his portable piano. And I want to give a message backstage to Scott to let him know we do already have a piano, so don't be the friendly one we have back there out. We have a very fine piano here, too. So, ladies and gentlemen, from New Orleans, one of the greats, Scott Kirby.
Thank you.
me an opportunity to introduce the next piece. In fact, here I'll tell a little story about Scott Joplin. I know some of you are always expecting our little Danita Fowler updates, and this year's Danita Fowler update is this. Danita is the niece, surviving niece of Scott Joplin, daughter of his brother Monroe. And she lives in the San Francisco Bay Area. And every once in a while, near me, and I get to see her every once in a while and say hello and catch up on the next ailments and what's going on in the neighborhoods. And I call her every once in a while, a couple weeks or so. And she's doing okay, she's still in there. She's telling me little stories about what's going on with her building. And she's always very appreciative that the chance to stop over and send regards to people who like to say hello to her. But this year, I just happened to see her about 2 weeks ago, and I said, I'll just say Sedalia again, Danita. And she was here in 1983, only had a Scott Joplin stamp. Remember when postage was 20 cents? Remember Scott Joplin? Well, postage was 20 cents. And in 1983, she came here for that commemoration with her two nieces from Texarkana, who still live down in Texarkana. And they had a great time. She remembers it quite well. She recalls details to me when she was next there. But most of all, the message from Danita is that she wanted everybody in Sedalia to know that she had just a terrific time, and she wishes more than anything, and she truly means, if she could just make one more trip, if she were mobile enough, she would love to get on a plane and come to Sedalia, Missouri. She really, really loves the place, and she's so appreciative that all of you help celebrate the music of Scott Joplin. So if I stretch that story out long enough for me to be able to play the next tune for you, no, I hope that I will carry soon the messages from some of the people I've talked with me today back to Danita. I'll play for you original records. And I'd like to bring out a pianist for this particular event, someone who I rehearse with very infrequently because he lives 3,000 miles away, Glenn Jenks. There's a section of it which apparently may have been a really an adaptation of somebody else's piece, H.O. Wheeler. And so Charles Daniels, who was one of the people looking at the publisher, and H.O. Wheeler are credited with writing this piece. And I collect orchestrations, not the piano sheet music. Even though the piano sheet music says original writers from Scott Joplin, the orchestration does not have Joplin's name on it at all. So kind of a funny little thing, but take my word for it. This piece by Joplin rightfully deserves to be on this program, Original Rags. various instruments, actually, some more string instruments, even, which I always like to see. Right now, however, one of the very finest ragtime pianists in the world. Tardy Waldo was here in the early years when we were just getting this festival off the ground, about 5 inches off the ground in 1974. I look back on those times very fondly, and with a lot of new friends. We saw the ragtime being played by so many fine people, none of us knew each other, but among the very first people that I recall having met in the world of ragtime, and I had such immediate respect for, it's a real pleasure, particularly for me, to bring up to you now a very good friend and one of the very best pianists I hope you'll enjoy, Mr. Terry Waldo.
Scott Joplin, as you know, was suffering from the final stages of syphilis, and his mind was going slowly, and I think you can hear that in the work, actually. Only in the sense that it has some of the interesting ambiguities of what I think is truly very ragtime. And Scott Joplin was the master of getting a great deep sense of sadness in his work. I think that Magnetic sort of expresses that. You have sort of a surface gaiety, but underneath it you have a lot of depth of feelings, as it were, like great comedy. When you see a Charlie Chaplin film, it's funny as hell, but it's also things that you can identify with, that they have a really good tune on a deep level. So if I play the damn thing correctly, all that will come out.
just a little bit about this group. They started off just about the same time, maybe a little earlier, than our first festival in 1974. And they were part of the beginnings of this festival. A little string group. And at the time, it was a trio with mandolin, guitar, and violin. And since then, they've had a personnel change, and they have things change with the group a little, and now they've acquired Bob Ault, who is now stealing, to join them on various instruments, but not violin. So it's Bob Ault with his instruments and the other two guys, guitar and mandolin, which leaves me with the question, isn't there a job opening now for violinists? Ladies and gentlemen, the entire string band.
Thank you. 2 years ago, we played this concert.
fact, even one of the young composers was there and played the pieces and analyzed them. It was great to get kids involved. That's one of the points of this thing, to get some music education back in schools, so some fun with music. But I suggest you just gave me a great idea. I think, Glenn, the next thing we ought to do with the youth of our country is send, have a whole day where we just get a day off of school and every kid starts scavenging around for Joplin's lost opera, The Guest of Honor. How about that kind of idea? Maybe we'll find it. Maybe not. Ladies and gentlemen, some very fine pianist and one of the people directly responsible for many of the wonderful things happening in this festival, Glenn Jenks.
Thanks, David. That's very kind. This is one of Scott Joplin's most unusual pieces called Euphonic Sounds.
Showed up, someone told me about the festival, and she came in and took played behind the scenes, a house party, not on the concert stage. But soon she became a favorite performer of many of the people who come to this festival, and she has written compositions, she now has several recordings, and she's gone one step beyond, as some of us do. Meaning Blais decided to have her own Ragtime Festival, not that this one wasn't good enough for her, but that she wanted to bring all the fun to her home in Montreal. So she has had a festival in Montreal. This year, she's presenting Ragtime musicians again in the summer. Will be as part of a larger festival going on in Montreal. Very active and a really great performer and fun person. Ladies and gentlemen, Meaning Blais. Bink's Waltz. in Michigan. Bob Milne is a writer as well as a pianist, a composer, and an arranger, probably a piano tuner, and repairs and builds in the way, but completely involved in business. He's even gone one step beyond another direction where few ragtime bands have gone before. He's just completed writing his piano concerto in ragtime. Perhaps one day we'll be extravagant enough here at Ault, so we'll be able to play piano concertos for you. In the meantime, the journeyman piano player himself is the Bob Milne. involved with the schools, but I was thinking about this a couple of days ago. I and a few other people started coming in early to this festival and talking about performance, coming a little early, and we started to have our own little parties, just get together sessions, and we start playing racks with each other and show each other what racks we've written, and talking ragtime. And things just stretch out all day, and very busy. And then I was thinking, this is the only music festival I know of where most of the performers are completely exhausted before the opening ceremonies. So we are having a great time. As I said, Tony Caramia is up next. He's known not only for his outstanding ragtime piano playing, he also plays some of the faster styles, virtuosic styles, as we say, very bubbly kind of pieces, fast, and he's extremely confident, gets every note all the time, and he's well known for that. So ladies and gentlemen, I would like to bring out for you Tony Caramia. Would you like to hear him again?
Thank you.
Joplin, Oklahoma. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Mitch Meador. frightened about the Scott Joplin house. The next performer is now associated with, you know, in St. Louis, there's one of the houses that Joplin has owned and lived in, now has a plaque on it and has been fixed up and has stuff in it, and it's known as the Scott Joplin house. And I had visited that, and I thought to myself, I hope I live a good, full life doing wonderful things so that someday people can drive by my house and go, that's the David Reffkin house. Or maybe I'll just move into Scott Joplin's, I've saved a lot of time. Jan Douglas has been with this festival on and off over the years. He's a scholar, a teacher, and a performer. And he has been very, very recently, and I can say this is hot newsflash, been declared the new administrator of the Scott Joplin House in St. Louis. Ladies and gentlemen, Jay Hamilton Douglas.
Thank you.
We're going to present a singer, someone who has been on the stage many times and has been a great ragtime song. So ragtime, of course, is a vocal music as well, syncopated songs. And so I'd like to bring out someone who does remind us occasionally about our ragtime songs and the words to some of these things. And you'd be surprised that even a Joplin rag eventually was given words anyway. Hear all about this from the vocalist and Frennessy accompanying her, Dick Zimmerman. First appearance at the Scott Joplin Ragtime Festival, a very fine classical pianist and performer of novelty ragtime, I'd like to introduce Mr. Phillip Dyson.
Thank you.
Australia. This is sort of a world tour of Ragtime today. We have John Dill, who is a pianist, who has sent me a number of tapes that he's done over there. People send me, because I have a Ragtime radio program in San Francisco, and I'm very fortunate to receive a number of recordings from these artists. And it's amazing how different and distinctive many of them are. And John Dill has a particularly distinctive style. I hope you enjoy it. From Perth, Australia, John Dill.
Thank you.
happens if somebody's in the state of Maine, you tell me where he's from. And the group also specializes in doing concerts of classical music mixed in with his ragtime, and vice versa. And then he has him rolling in the aisles. Ladies and gentlemen, Masanobu Ikemiya.
Favorite, anyway, with her, okay. soon as we are through the concert and coming on as our last act, we have a rather difficult rehearsal to do down here. So, any of you in the audience who are going to be on the music hall show, please be right down here immediately after the performance is out, because we have to get started rehearsing. So that's number one. And also, of course, backstage. We'll get that started just as soon as possible. The rest of you, if you could just sort of make your way out to the various exits as quickly as you can, that will give us a quiet place to rehearse. And
all goes well. If all goes well,
you're going to see a terrific music hall show tonight. And again, it's theoretically going to start at 10, folks, but you know, we're coming from a little bit further away, and we don't know. So, you know, it's about 10-ish on the low hot time, right? And remember, the bar is going to be open, and the more that you drink, the better we are. Okay, maybe one or two introduce our surprise phenomenon.
Thank you. This. That's not happening on stage. By the way, I want to tell you that I've been thinking through all these performances about the joy of playing Ragtime at Sedalia and how wonderful it is, as I said, to get together with all our friends and play this great music that we're so proud of and that we work so hard during the year. And it's just totally joyful. It comes to Sedalia. And I was trying to think, is there one word that sums it up, that brings together all the joy and happiness that all of the performers feel about coming to Sedalia, Missouri? Is there one thing that says it all? So when I say to that performer, that word knows what I'm talking about. And I realized the word last night, about 6 o'clock. The word is catfish. From the San Francisco area, and as I said, I have a radio program, Ragtime radio program, called the Ragtime Machine. I almost literally fell over this group when I first met them. They were on the sidewalk, much like homeless people, at Ocean Beach, on the very west coast of the country, and I heard them playing a couple of rags, and I said, sounds pretty good. Now, this is some years ago. You guys have a tape? No, they're just starting out. They don't really know what they're doing there. They're having a good time playing Ragtime. That's all I know. So I said, well, sometime, let me know how you're doing. If you find anywhere inside, and if you'd like to send it over, I'd like to put it on a radio show. So sometime later, maybe Sunday or recording, I sent in some announcements, and I put the announcements on the air. I said, here's where they're playing. I mean, the group is bold enough. Let's go here. And very soon after that, I started reading and preparing for this festival. They're playing all over town in San Francisco and the East Bay and Oakland and Berkeley. And now they are in Sedalia, Missouri, and they are stars. And I feel that I am directly responsible for this festival. And I'm proud to bring them out. Both Grumpus. Sitting there, you say, if I have a wedding band.